Honestly, the quality of rhetoric amongst bloodthirsty rioters these days. shadow.
Certainly don't look like a blood-crazed revolutionary. The hood is a bit sinister, though, if you don't mind my saying.
Serving as rear guard, are you? Convenient how that puts several locked doors between you and the fighting.
Oh, I'm not here at all. Not officially, anyway. But how often does one find the opportunity to poke about in a king's private study?
Looking for anything in particular?
State secrets, private correspondences, personal treasures, that sort of thing.
I do hope we're not eyeing the same prize.
Name it.
Certain letters written to the king. Ripe for misunderstanding, should the wrong men find them.
I see. Well, then perhaps we can help each other. I believe the king has built a hidden vault somewhere in here. If only we could find it.
You were saying?
Very nicely done, my friend. Incredible.
Find your prize.
A cornucopia, yes. And you?
Believe so. Yes. This is it. That should take care of that.
And may I suggest we leave? Quickly.
What is that?
Our way out. Cover me, would you?
Search everything! I want those documents!
Him?
Yes, Captain Rui has that effect on people.
Friend of yours?
A persistent thorn I haven't quite managed to pluck out.
He has information I need. I need to get back up there.
In this mess, you'll never find him again. Come with me, I have a better idea. You handled yourself well back there. I don't suppose you've ever considered military service.
I'm not much for following orders.
Ah, the bane of generals and statesmen everywhere. An individualist. I know the feeling. Men like us have a great advantage over most in the army. You see, we can think for ourselves. If you joined up today, you'd be a marshal in 10 years, guaranteed.
A generous offer, but no.
Where the heart leads, a man must follow. Look me up if you ever change your mind. Bonaparte is my name. Napoleon Bonaparte. Second lieutenant of artillery, for now.
Arno Dorian.
A pleasure. And as a personal favor, if anyone asks, I was never here. Watch the whole thing from a furniture shop across the carousel.
A face in the crowd, of course.
What now?
Just a moment. You may want to take cover.
Everything all right, sir?
Fine, Corporal. Superb shot. Regular drills are critical to a regiment's success.
We should be going, sir.
We part ways here.
What about Rui?
Give me a few days. I'll see what I can learn of his current posting. Perhaps I can arrange an introduction. Be well.
Tell me who you're protecting.
What do you want?
Talk.
You've got the wrong man.
Stop and discuss your opinions with
people. You can't just accost people in the street.
This morning, I was accosted by three men carrying some poor soul's head atop a pike. Seems they mistook my uniform for a mark of nobility and demanded I shout, "Long live the Republic," to prove my allegiance.
I suppose handing out tricolor cockades is now passé. What did you do?
I shouted, "Long live the Republic."
A man of principle.
Life is more valuable than dignity. But this is what happens when you give command of the government to half-starved lunatics and command of the army to bloodthirsty savages.
Rui.
I wanted him assigned to some out-of-the-way garrison, but the man redefines the term friends in high places. He's untouchable.
But you know where I can find him.
Rumor about the barracks is that he and a unit of his cronies plan on marching on the Grand Châtelet this afternoon. If he were to meet with an accident, few in France would suffer. My career certainly wouldn't.
Well, practice your speech making.
Nobody try anything.
Ah!
the bitches! Silence!
All right.
Don't make this harder on yourselves. No tricks! This is inhuman!
You can thank me by getting to the walls and stopping these killings.
Hinderer! orders to remove us from this hall. You must also get authority to use force, for we shall yield to nothing but bayonets!
Ah, but to administer is to govern is to reign. That is the essence of the problem.
Mr. Mirabeau.
Pathetic, isn't it? Surely, France deserves better.
What was that?
Berlin de Luxembourg.
Roy, clean up your mess, it's time.
Told you I could make him talk.
You've done well, Captain. Breathe.
The price of grain is higher than ever, Grandmaster. Our agents are in place to divert the shipments to our docks. They await only your command.
Good. Starve them. Through famine and fury, they will see their false masters for what they are, but do it gradually.
What you're asking will take at least a year, Grandmaster. If not two. Thank you.
What do you know about grain merchants?
Good to see you too. Most of them are very poor just now, bye.
I have a lead on Germain. He has a woman named Marie buying up grain shipments and diverting them to a private dock.
Marie Levesque?
You know her.
The Levesques have been Templars since the Third Crusade. Marie was the only one who argued against Germain's exile. I'm not surprised she's thrown in with him.
Any idea where we might find her?
Not her, no. But what little grain makes it to Paris these days is unloaded at the Hôtel de Ville docks.
Promising. I'll start there.
Perhaps I can learn something of Madame Levesque's whereabouts.